Hey YouTubers, how's everybody doing today? So I have a hopefully quick and easy project that I've been waiting to do for a while. I was waiting for the weather to warm up so the garage was warm. What I want to do is on my Royal Enfield over here where you have the name Royal Enfield embossed on the case, and then also on the other side on the crank cover there, I want to paint in the words with some gloss black paint. I wanted to wait till it warmed up so that the paint would adhere better. When it's cold, you might have adhesion problems, right? So today's the day. What I've got in preparation to do this is I've got some paint thinner, because the first thing you have to do is you have to clean all the dirt, grime, as well as any wax buildup that you might have on those cases. All that's got to be gotten rid of for the paint to stick. So I'm going to start with some paint thinner on some paper towels. And then I'll use some Q-tips to really get in the corners. And then wipe that down, let it dry. And then I've got this wax and tar remover. I'll do the same thing with this stuff, and as the name suggests, it gets rid of wax, tar, grease, etc. Let that dry, and then I will take some, this is Testors model paint, Testors, alright, can you see that? I got gloss black for this bike because the side covers are gloss black, and the stripe is a gloss black, so I figure it'll play well off of that. As opposed to, I did the similar thing here to my Kawasaki. That's a semi-gloss black. Now, it looks faded, but it's not. That's actually wax buildup, so I'd have to clean that. But this was almost completely gone. There was no black in there at all. So that looks really nice. And this stuff, it's enamel paint, so it should hold up to the heat of the engine well enough. This is just a cap off of an old spray can. I've got some paint thinner in there to clean my brushes off. And then as far as brushes go, I just went to the Mart of Wall and I picked up this easy grip brush set. There were 12 brushes. They had a hard grip brush set too, a little cheaper, but I figured I'd splurge and do the easy grip. It's a joke. I've already used some of these for other things, so they're gone. I believe I'm going to go with either one of these two with the pointy tip for the larger case on this side. Because basically, you know, I want something that's going to get decent amount of coverage quickly enough, but that also give me some control. And then I'm thinking of using this teeny tiny one for the other side. My issue here is I may have problems. I've used this to apply some silicone grease or a dielectric grease to stuff, which that'll be a problem. But I've washed it really thoroughly in the paint thinner there, so I'm hoping that'll be okay. And if not, I can use these brushes. So the idea is clean these off, paint inside the lines as best as possible, but then I'll take a rag with a little paint thinner on it, and anything that's gotten outside of there, just kind of wipe it off before it dries, and then let this stuff dry. I can go to the other side, paint that side in, wipe it off. This side should be dry enough at that point to reapply. I think I want to do definitely two coats, maybe three. Okay, so that's the project. I'll set you up so you can see what I'm doing. And if you would please too, listen to the background. I'm going to have some of my favorite music playing from my friend Brianna. I will have a link of her SoundCloud stuff in the description. I think it's SoundCloud. If it's not, I'll give you the link to where it's at. I just absolutely love her music. I think it's fantastic. And I listen to it all the time. Also, I keep finding, you know, some of the stuff I'm playing in the background, I keep getting these copyright infringement issues. She's given me permission to play her music in the background, and I also like the idea of supporting friends and people I know who do art and music that I love and that maybe you'll love too. So keep an ear out for that. Check out her stuff. Click on her link if you would. And let her know where you found out about her music. I'd be real happy if she knew that I was spreading the joy. All right? All right, I'm going to set you up on the tripod and we'll get going. All right, I got you guys off to the side a little bit so I don't get my head in the way like I usually do. I've got my supplies over to the side and I'm going to start cleaning, getting all the grease and stuff off of here. In the background, you can hear Brianna's music. Enjoy! Paper towel, paint thinner, generous dollop, and wipe. Now the idea is to get inside there. That's the most important part. So I'm trying to just get it to soak in. Makes sense. As much as I can. Then I'll come back with the Q-tips. I don't know if you can see like that dirt. So that's dirt and wax and whatever else build up in there. You can see it right in there. I'm just gonna go straight for the Q-tips now. Just dipping it in. The better you prep this and clean this up, the better results you're gonna have with your paint. Yeah, my Q-tip is just turning. Can you see that? Where are you? There you are. Look. So it may look clean, but it ain't clean. Clean it. Squeaky clean. The worst will be like not cleaning it well enough, starting the paint, and then your paint just starts fisheyeing and not adhering well. It'll just look terrible. All right, you get the picture. I'm gonna keep doing this. I'll try and play some music in the background while I fast forward. So I'm done with the paint thinner on this side. Now I'm gonna go back over it with the wax and tar remover. This will do a better job of getting all of that stuff out of there. What I'm basically doing is that as it's spilling, I'm swiping it up. And then I'm soaking the Q-tip so that as I press in here, it actually builds up some extra liquid. And clean it up better. Make sense? All right, I'm gonna continue with that. wax and tar remover as well. Just there's a spot in here that I can't seem to clean out. So I have these dental tools. If you talk to your dentist, usually they get rid of this stuff after a while. They may just give it to you, but these are great for restoring and rebuilding. And so I'm just using that tool to scrape that little bit of gunk off, loosen it up, and then I'll take a Q-tip with some wax and tar remover and pick it up. There it goes. See? So the better you prep this, the better it's going to come out in the end. Prep is usually 90% of it. The only other thing to watch out with these Q-tips is they will leave little hairs, you know, like little cotton hairs. So make sure and wipe all that off too. So I'm just going to take a dry paper towel now and wipe that all down. Make sure there's no cotton or anything. And that wax and tar stuff, it dries pretty well on its own. You don't have to worry about it too much. I see a few errant hairs. And these sometimes leave lint too. So you could use, they have lint-free ones. You could use a tack cloth, actually, a painting tack cloth, which it's, as the name suggests, it's slightly tacky and it picks up errant fibers, hairs, dust, etc. But I'm not too worried about that for this. Like if I was painting a gas tank or something, I would definitely use a tack cloth. All right, I'm happy with that. I think so anyway. Not too bad. On to the paint. So like I said, Testors gloss black paint is my choice for this project. I'm gonna shake it up a bit. I think I'll be okay. Maybe with this blue brush. Oh, also another thing, a lot of times when you buy brushes new, they may have a bit of a coating on it. Usually water takes that off, but you need to get that off before you start using them. So I'm dipping this in some mineral spirits paint thinner to clean it. But you gotta make sure that's all really taken off before you start painting or it'll thin out your paint. And I don't wanna thin out my paint. Okay, that's clean. This is shaken up. So now a little trick I learned, I was pinstriping for a little while. It was fun. I may pick it up again. Instead of just being up in the air, you can support one hand with the other and just start filling in. One other thing I'm trying to do, put enough paint to get a nice covering for the first layer, but not so much that it's pooling up in the corners. You might see too, as I'm cleaning this up, I'm using both hands. It just gives me more stability, you know. I'm resting one hand here and then helping guide the other hand. That's just a little trick, again, that I picked up from pinstriping. Because those little pinstriping brushes, man, they bounce all over the place, you know, and you need to keep it steady. Okay. That's the first, here, what do you think? Not too bad, huh? Kind of makes it pop out. So I'm gonna go to the other side. I'm gonna do the same process, you know? I'm gonna clean it up and then paint it. I'm gonna try that little brush I mentioned because I am definitely gonna need it. I think this is a little too fat for that side. But I don't think you need to watch all that. So I'll bring you back when that's done. And then by the time I'm done with that side, I can do a second coat on this side. So hang tight. I just wanted to give you a before shot of this side. I've spent about 10 minutes cleaning this, and I'm pretty happy with it. It's very hard to get in all these nooks and crannies, but again, you really have to clean all the crud out of there before you can start painting. All right. Another thing, I mentioned I waited for it to get warm. Well, it's like 100 degrees today, and I think that's also affected me slightly adversely in that the paint is getting thick quickly. But no big deal. Anyway, just wanted to show you that, and now I'm gonna get to painting. Wish me luck. So as you can see, I just finished filling that in for the first time. There's a lot of over paint. I'm letting it dry just a little bit, and then I'm gonna wipe it down with my rag with the teeniest, tiniest bit of paint thinner on it, making sure it doesn't flow into the cracks and crevices. Get it? I'll try and do it one-handed. So there's the teeniest, tiniest bit of thinner on the tip of my finger on that rag there. And now I'm just, not too much pressure, just wiping and trying to get off all that excess that's above the recess. Makes sense? Now, because it's so hot, this stuff is drying pretty quickly. So I may be having a slightly harder time than I imagined. But I think I'll be fine. See, look at that. So not too much thinner. You don't want it to wash into the recesses, right? You get what I'm saying. If you don't, just tell me. There you go. Not too bad, huh? What a difference. All right, I'm gonna go back to the other side and do a second coat. Let's see how that goes. Ready for the second coat on this side. My head might block you a bit, but sorry. Just how it is. I'm no professional. But I do want you to learn. I'm trying to make my videos shorter without sacrificing showing you everything I'm dealing with. You know, because that's what it's, besides hanging out, which is my favorite part of this, it's also, I want you to see that stuff happens. Like, it's not always as straightforward as people will make you believe. You get it? All right, second round. Second coat is done. If you notice, I actually went over the edges more than before because I realize how easy it is to clean off. And I want to get all the side walls painted properly. And there's a fine balance between too much paint and not enough paint. So you just got to play with it. Okay, I'm going to wipe that clean, go to the other side. I think two coats is enough. Well, here you have it. Two coats. I really like it. Here's a zoomed out look. When you get closer, you know, you may see some brush strokes or something, but it just is how it is. I did two coats. I think that'll be fine. If it's not, at some point I could do another coat. Let me show you the other side. I'm really happy with how this came out. It really makes it pop. I almost didn't do these teeny tiny lines inside and out, but I ended up doing it, and I'm glad I did because it looks really, really good. Quick thing on this side, I did something different. Instead of using mineral spirits or paint thinner first, and then the tar and wax remover. I just used the tar and wax remover, wax and tar remover, and it seemed to help, because on the other side, when I was painting, I was getting a little bit of bad coverage in a couple of spots because it seemed like the paint thinner hadn't fully evaporated. So you may just want to use the wax and tar remover. However, clean it really, really well. This thing was full of old polishing compound from the factory, and I've sprayed these a little bit with some S100 wax detail stuff. So really make sure you clean it well. And the other thing I realized is, after you paint it on, let it dry a little bit. Not fully dry, of course, but don't let it just be wet either. Let it kind of get a little tacky, because then when you use your rag with the teeniest bit of mineral spirits on it and you wipe it off, you seem to have better results. It cleans up well, as you can see right there. All right, folks, that was a quick one. Can you believe it? Little things make a big difference. Please like, please subscribe. Really, please listen to my friend's music. It's so good. I rock out to it all the time. And have a good one. We'll talk to you soon. Bye for now. I forgot to mention, I'm going to let this dry overnight. I'm not going to start the bike. I'm not going to ride the bike for at least 12 hours, if not longer, just to let that fully cure and dry. And then when I start riding, the heat from the engine should kind of help it do a final cure. All right, so that's an important point. Don't just paint it and then go riding. Okay, so again, on that note, take care, and we will see you soon with some more fun and exciting projects. Take it easy.